Hello everyone, welcome to TalentSprint. So in this session of history, we shall discuss the first topic, that is introduction to Indian history. So how much do you know about Indian history? As far as general studies examination is concerned, for India, the Indian history is asked, particularly SSC and RRB examinations. So Indian history is asked, so we shall deal about Indian history in detail in the coming chapters. So the first topic we shall discuss, the topic called Introduction to Indian History. So what is history? So history is derived from a Greek word historia. So historia means inquiry or investigation. So generally I want to know about my past. So what happened in my past? Who were my ancestors? How they used to live? What were the tools they used to use? How they built their own houses? How they led their own life? So inquiry into the past is nothing but the history. So it is derived from a Greek word called historia. Okay, so who is considered as father of history? It is Herodotus. He is considered as the father of world history. He is a 5th century Greek historian. He is considered to be father of the world history. Okay, moving on to how history can be traced. How can I know about the history of my past, whether it may be world history or Indian history? Okay, so history can be traced through following methods. So the first is, people used to write on the walls. So such writing on walls is called as inscriptions, and the study of inscriptions is called as epigraphy. This is a very repeated question in many general studies examinations. So the study of inscriptions is called as epigraphy. So the writings on the walls, we know the script, or if we decipher the script, we can know the when it was written. Okay, next is inscriptions is done. The next is books. So some people used to write on books, leaves, etc. Leaves maybe they may be getting dried up, but books they stay for a longer while, right? So because of books we know some things about the past. Next is tools. What were the tools, different types of tools they were using, whether metal tools or stone tools or bronze, copper. All these tools were used by different civilization people, like Indus Valley, they used to use bronze. Okay, the later Vedic people, they used to use iron, like that. So how the people were using different tools. Next is painting on walls. So painting on walls means it is called as mural painting. Okay, example is Ajanta Caves. Hope you have visited Ajanta Caves or Ellora Caves. You can see the very beautiful paintings, Bhimbetka Caves. Okay, so they depict or they give some information about the history of our past. Next is coins. So some rulers or people used to stamp on some coins. Okay, the Guptan rule is called as golden age because they used to give us, they gave us the gold coins. Okay, the study of coins is called as numismatics. Okay, so through coins we can know some past. The last is radiocarbon dating. The very best isotope of the all living organisms is carbon-14 or C-14. C-14 is available in all the living organisms. Through it, we can know the age of that living organism. So this, in this way, the radiocarbon dating will be very useful for us to know about the history of the past. So these are the methods, various methods, which the historians use or the archaeologists use to know the past of any country or any place or any civilization. Moving on to Indian history. So Indian history is divided into various stages. We shall know about them now, and we shall study in the later topics also the details of the Indian history. The first is how the Indian history is divided. So according to a historian called James Mill, the Indian history is divided into three parts. The first is ancient history, then is medieval history, and the next is modern history. So how he has divided this, we shall see in the coming slides. So first, Indian history timeline. The Indian history timeline dates back from 2 million BC to 1947 AD. 2 million BC. 1 million is 10 lakhs. It means 20 lakh BC. What is this BC and AD? So BC stands for before Christ and AD stands for Anno Domini. So before the birth of the Christ and after the birth of Christ is called as Anno Domini. Okay, some people say AD also, they call it as Common Era. And before Common Era and Common Era. BCAD, like that. Okay, hope you are clear with this. So James Mill has divided Indian history into three parts: ancient, medieval and modern. So now we shall discuss the first one, that is in ancient history of India. So ancient history is dominated by Hindu rulers as per James Mill. So most of the rulers were Hindus. Okay, and it dates back from 2 million BC to 700 AD. Okay, the exact dates are not possible to timeline for any historian. So approximately 2 million BC to approximately 700 AD. The first Muslim ruler entered in 712 AD, Muhammad bin Qasim, right? So approximately 700 AD. Particularly about ancient history, we don't exactly need the years. Okay, approximately we'll have the years. Okay, but for modern and medieval histories, we need the exact years. Okay, so the ancient history includes the following. What are those following? The first is Stone Age. Okay, it starts with the 2 million BC. Next comes Indus Valley Civilization. Next, Vedic Age. Next, Buddhism, Jainism, Mauryan rule, Magadhan rule, Sufism, Bhakti movement, Guptan rule, Vardhan rule. All these were included in the ancient history. Okay, this is about the ancient history. Next is medieval history, and medieval history is dominated by Muslim rulers. How Muslim rulers have entered India? With the entry of Muslim rulers into India, the medieval history starts, and it dates back from 700 AD to 1600 AD. Okay, with the entry of the British rule in India, or the East India Company rule in India, the medieval history will end. Okay, so what are the things which the medieval history includes? So medieval history includes the entry of Muslim rulers in India, Vijayanagara Empire, Delhi Sultanate, Mughal Empire. All these, some of the important ones are included into the medieval history. Next is modern history. So ancient history is dominated by Hindu rulers, medieval history is dominated by Muslim rulers, then modern history is dominated by British rulers. So this is a basic classification for James Mill to categorize into the Indian history into ancient, medieval and modern histories. So modern history is categorized or dates back from 1600 AD to the date when we attain our independence, that is 15th August 1947. So 1600 AD to 1947 AD is the timeline of modern history. Okay, and what does modern history includes? It includes the entry of European traders into India. Okay, first Vasco da Gama comes to India, who is a Portuguese person. He comes in 1498 AD. Then like that Dutch, then English, then French, like that people will join to come to India to trade with the, particularly they wanted spices. The India was famous for spices in India. Okay, so they came to loot our spices as traders. Then they'll slowly start to rule. Next, the British rule will dominate out of all the foreigners. How they eliminate other French people, Dutch people, all these Portuguese people, how the British rule will start in India and how they rule in India. Then how, because of the autocracy rule of the British people, the Indians have to face a lot of problems, and they will start Indian independence movements. The famous Gandhiji and other leaders, how the first revolt of 1857 happens, how the various independence movements like Salt Satyagraha or Dandi March, non-cooperation movement, Quit India movement, and how we attain independence on 15th August 1947. So with attainment of 15th independence, that is on 15th August 1947, we'll complete our modern history, the total history part of India. So this is all for this session in this topic. We shall meet in the next topics. Thank you so much.